today I'm going to review this NAT CD player and the 522. And I have this thing came with a, well, a owner's manual, as you can see over here, a thick manual, and with the official remote control. Let me see where the thing is. Yes, over here. This is the remote control, you know. Not sure if it is working. Well, probably, but the batteries will be empty from this thing anyway. Well, I sold the complete set with the amplifier, the 704, I think it was, yes, for 90 euro. That's very, very cheap, very cheap. And because normally they are worth 175, 150, 175, but yeah, you know, if I want to sell something, I want to sell it. I'm a very bad sales guy, you know. I don't have the patience to sell things. And I thought, okay, I sell everything for 90 euro, the complete set, so with the amplifier. And then this guy came to my house and he said, I only want the amplifier. I don't want the cassette deck, I don't want the CD player. I said, okay, I think maybe I can get 10 or 20 euro more for the CD player. And before I put this thing on the market, I saw this is a very good CD player. And people ask a lot of money for the CD player normally. And this thing is from 1997, so not an old one. And well, I sold the complete set, so the cassette deck and the CD player, for 35 euro. I think also that is very low, because when I saw these prices afterwards, I thought, well, I must be crazy to sell it this cheap. But yeah, if I pay cheap, you know, I'm glad when I have my money back, you know. And when I make 10, 20 euro profit, I'm happy, you know. I don't want to make 50 euro. As long as I can review it, because that's why I make my videos, for the reviews. That's why I buy these things, to review it for you guys, you know, to test these things out. And, well, I have to pack it in, but then I thought, well, I reviewed the complete set, but not the CD player separate. So I tested the amplifier and the tuner, but I didn't test the CD player. So that's why I'm testing it now. I'm reviewing it before I put it on the post, you know, the package. And so this thing is from 1997. Yes, it comes with the remote control and it is almost 5 kilo. That's a heavy thing for a CD player. And today I'm gonna test it with this CD, an old one, and you can see it is yellow. The outside is yellow from smoking. I smoke that much in my house. And I will do part three. As you can see over here, these are the songs, part three. If you want to see back later what song it was, just go scroll back and you see the number what is corresponding with the CD player. Okay? So these are the numbers you see over here. Is zooming good for you? So, because don't ask me what song was it on this minute or this, what song it was. Just watch this piece back and you know what song it was, okay? And then this is how it works. You click the thing on, this on and knob, and this is no disc, of course, and this is how it opens, and the thing works fine. Like, you see, often when the CD player is old, these things won't close anymore that good, or it doesn't open because of the rubber belts inside, but this thing works fine. And let me test out if the remote control is still working. I don't believe it, but no, it doesn't work. I think this remote control, see, I don't see a remote. Well, this, I think this is the remote device, but I think the batteries are empty. That's normal after a while. And this is how it sounds, my friends. And today I use my Zoom microphone over there. Let me zoom in for you. This is my Zoom microphone. One of the two, I have two, but the other one I have a problem, because it only takes those normal batteries, and this one also takes rechargeable batteries, but That is a problem because normally the other one also have to work on rechargeable batteries. But okay, I use my old one and the sound will be as good as that new one, you know. The mics are identical in this one as in the old one. And this is how it sounds. Let me see, everything is correct. Yes, play, where's play over here? This is how it sounds.
It's wrong. The magic. bomb, a 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 dang, a dang, dang, a ding, a dong, a ding, boom.
Spin this complete CD because I think the sound is terrible, and I'm not sure if it is because of this CD. You know, it's possible that this CD is from a bad quality, 1991, from Star Direct. You know, but I earlier tested this combination through my phone. You know, and what I heard with Flux through my from my phone on this amp, it is a fantastic sounding thing. And when I connect this CD player, I heard something completely different. And it can be that the CD is not good, but I'm not sure why it wouldn't be good. And so this is, you know, with CD players, this is technique from 1997. You know, and the internal DAC of my phone, yes, is a DAC from 2013. No, that's a difference from 16 years. You know, and DACs today's DACs are so much better than DACs from 1997. You know, and I think that's the difference. I'm not sure. Maybe it's because of the CD, and maybe this CD player is a good CD player, probably. But maybe you need another CD, I'm not sure, you know, but what I just heard I have pain in my ears, you know, because the sound is awful, bad, you know. And it sounds, this good sounding, superb sounding amplifier, you know, when I connect my phone on it with that very good DAC, that Saber DAC. That's a very good DAC, my friends, you know. If you can find a device with Saber DACs inside, you know, it is always a good device, you know. And but 1997, not sure what DAC is inside this thing. It was not a cheap CD player. This was a very good CD player when tested in 1997. But and I think that's the reason why I don't spin CDs anymore, you know. You need a very good CD player, up-to-date CD player, or maybe if I play this CD player in direct in line. Not sure if this thing have a direct in connection, not sure. Maybe then the sound is different, you know. But guys, believe me, when you have a CD player in your house, you are a CD lover, you know. And if you need a new phone, try the LG V10, V20. I'm not sure the V30 or now they have the V40, I think. Try that one. Don't buy an iPhone if you are a music lover. If you are a music lover, then you shouldn't buy an iPhone or a Samsung. Then you should buy a Lenovo, a LG. LG V10. That was the first one that only had one DAC, but that is good enough. Also, my phone had the same DAC as that LG V10. Beautiful sound. And buy a phone on its sounds, on the DAC inside, you know. There are more phones, not only the LG, but LG is at the moment the best phone for sound. And I talked with Ivor and he told me, well, it is too compact, you know, too crampy to be good, you know. That is his opinion, you know. And that's why he preferred playing his music over a dedicated DAC, you know, or a DAC. But believe me, guys, if you ever try a LG V40, V30, or V20, or V10, you will be surprised, you know. And if you have a CD, you know, just put that CD in your computer or laptop and make them as flex and place those flex on that phone, and you will see that phone, you will not believe it, but that phone will sound better as your CD player, and that's because of that DAC, you know. Or you have to place a DAC between this CD player and the setup. But yeah, if you need a new phone, why shouldn't you buy a phone with a good DAC, so you can use that phone later. You know, if you buy another phone, when that phone that phone is old-fashioned, you know, you can always use it as a music player. Only buy a phone, you know, where you can place a extra external memory card. So my phone has 64 GB, and that's not much for music, but I can upgrade it with a 256 GB card. So together I have 300 GB. On music, if I buy this 256 card, you know, so I can have 300 GB on my card. And when this phone is finished as a phone, I will use it as my permanent music player, my friends. And that is called smart buying, you know. Buy that phone and use it as your, well, as your music player with that superb DAC inside. And I heard a difference right away, you know. And maybe this is a good CD player, maybe it's because of the CD, I'm not sure, but it sounded awful, and maybe the thing is good. I don't have time, you know. This was a quick review, and I picked out a good CD. I have plenty of CDs upstairs, but I have to pack this thing out in this beautiful weather. I have an appointment, I have to bring it to the post office, this box. And because I have an appointment, I go to the beach, so I don't have any more time to pick another CD out and to make my review, to test it if it is really the CD player or, you know, or the CD. So I'm sorry for that. And it's not a complete review in this way, you know. But anyway, I should have tested more CDs, then I can give you a more better opinion. But for this CD, it sounded just awful, you know. And it sounded like a cheap amplifier, and everybody knows how this thing sounds, beautiful sounds. And anyway, thanks for watching this video. Put your thumbs up if you like it. And for now I say ciao ciao.